One of the biggest events in Europe in the biotech sector is without a doubt BioEurope, and this year's event was held in the beautiful German city of Leipzig. As well as lots of colour-coded booths for one-on-one meetings, there were also plenty of exhibitors, so the biotech had an opportunity to find out about the biotech scenes in Portugal, Greece and Mauritius, as well as to talk to more than a dozen companies about their work.
So Sernova is a cell therapy therapeutics company. We're located in Canada, and the approach that we're looking at is using a cell therapy approach to actually find a functional cure for a number of major diseases. So to give you an example of what we're doing, I'm sure that everyone here knows people that are type 1 diabetic. So these are people that have lost the ability of their pancreas to produce insulin. In other words, the cells in the body have died. And so the issue is, for the past 100 years, is that these patients have had to take insulin injections to replace the function of the islets that are found in the pancreas. And they basically have to take these injections multiple times a day. And at the same time, they still get the diabetes side effects, such as heart disease, blindness, kidney disease, amputations, and this kind of thing over time. So they're living their lives constantly worrying about these kinds of issues. And if you're a child with a parent that is watching you, then these children and the parents are having to worry about children even dying in the middle of the night because they have something called hypoglycemia unawareness. So that's an issue that when you take an insulin injection, your blood sugar levels can drop to a point where you will go into a coma and potentially die. So this is really a complex problem. And there are several million patients in North America alone, and probably the same number in Europe of patients that are suffering from this disease. So what Sernova has done, and if you can imagine what we're working on, if you can imagine a patient now that has received a therapy where they don't have to worry about taking insulin injections anymore, and they can live completely normal lives. And that's what Sernova is working on. And so we have, our therapy involves three pieces, and it's really a platform technology whereby we have a small medical device that is placed deep under the skin. And when you place that under the skin, it's very, very porous. And the idea is that highly vascularized tissue will grow into that device and make an organ-like environment for new therapeutic cells. And so then, about 3 weeks later, we will place the therapeutic cells into the device. And our first approach has been using human donor islets, which are the real thing that actually function in your own body. And so then what we have, so that's the device. And the therapeutic cells can be, we're first working with human donor islets, but we have done a deal with Evotec just recently in May, whereby we're getting an unlimited supply of iPSC-derived stem cell technology that forms fully functional islets. So with that technology, we will be able to treat all patients that have type 1 diabetes going forward. The next part of the technology is, how do you protect these cells from the immune system? Because the purpose of our device is to form that organ-like environment and to hold the cells. The purpose of the cells is to, you know, make insulin run properly. But the third part is, how do you protect the cells from immune system attack? And so what we've been working on is a polymer solution where we're able to coat the cells with a cross-link polymer before they go into the device. And then that can allow those cells to be protected from the immune system without drugs. And this is a technology that we're actually developing and bringing to the clinic. So if we then talk a little bit about our clinical trials, we have been working at the University of Chicago now, and the patients that we're working on are the most severely diabetic patients. So these are people that have long-term type 1 diabetes. They have severe hypoglycemic events that are occurring, and they have to have no ability to produce any insulin in their bodies. And so at this point in time, very briefly, we have achieved insulin independence in three of our patients so far. And one of them is at a 2.5 year time point. So we have a technology that we believe is going to provide a functional cure for patients overall.
Right. And I assume from the way that you were talking about the actual mechanism that this will be applicable to other conditions as well down the line?
Yeah. We have two other types of therapies that we're working on. One is for patients that are having their thyroid gland removed. So if you think about it, the thyroid gland essentially provides the energy in your body to do what you do, similar to the engine in a car. And for patients that are having their thyroid gland removed, then the medications that they're given aren't sufficient enough to be able to make them have normal lives again. And so the side effects of not having your thyroid gland is that extreme depression, exhaustion, weight gain, this kind of thing. So what we're looking at is bringing the feedback loop, similar to type 1 diabetes, back from the brain to the thyroid gland to these patients again. So we're planning on starting a clinical trial in 2023 in that area. And the second indication that we've been working on is hemophilia A. And hemophilia is a bleeding disorder whereby the patients are missing a factor called factor 8. And we had a grant with a group in the European Union, a Horizon 2020 program, where we were able to develop a product through preclinical trials where we were able to take a sample of the patient's blood and then insert the gene for factor 8 and then place that into the device in preclinical models, and we showed that we were able to reverse the bleeding disorder in those preclinical models. And that product is, we're looking at doing optimization of dosing and then likely moving into the clinic with that product also. So this is an ex vivo gene therapy approach whereby instead of taking infecting all of the cells in your liver, you're basically just infecting the cells outside of the body and then placing it in our device. So it has a huge safety improvement profile from that perspective.
In terms of this being out there on the market to start curing
people. So I'll talk about our diabetes program first. So right now we're doing a phase 2 trial that is ongoing, and we have a number of patients that are insulin independent now. That really shows that our technology is working. And then as we're going forward, we're looking at treating a small additional number of patients and then potentially going to use those data to be able to talk to FDA about a pivotal trial. At the same time, the Evotec cells that we're working with right now, we're working to build the IND with Evotec currently. So we have been doing studies with cell pouch and the Evotec cells, and we're planning on being in the clinic for 2024. And the important thing there is that Evotec has taken on the responsibility to be the cell manufacturer for that product, both for clinical trials and for commercial purposes. So one of the most complicated things you have when you have a cell therapy program is really not just obtaining stem cells, but it's being able to do the differentiation protocol properly, being able to control it like a drug, and then having the GMP manufacturing facility to be able to have that product be able to get out to the world. And we have secured that with Evotec right now. So we move that into clinical trials in early 2024. It's going to be a huge game changer because now we're looking at not only treating a small group of patients, but also starting to move towards treating all patients that have type 1 diabetes. And the beautiful thing about that protocol that we have is that it is very tightly designed to work with the cells in our cell pouch, so that when we bring those cells and put them into the cell pouch, they will start functioning and producing insulin once they engraft or connect up to the blood supply. So it's a very, very efficient type of process. For the thyroid program, so right now we're working on preparing the IND and clinical protocol, et cetera, talking to regulatory authorities, and we're planning on being in the clinic in 2023. And for the hemophilia program, then we have some optimizing preclinical work that we're planning for the very near future. And then once we do that, then we'll be looking at bringing that product into the clinic. But when we look at our type 1 diabetes program, aside from providing a functional cure for these patients, which I'm very, very confident that we're going to be able to do for the first time in 100 years, from the investor perspective, we have also talked to insurance companies and had independent studies done, which have basically come back and said that they would pay approximately $300,000 per patient for this treatment. And you might ask, why? Why is that so much more expensive than insulin? And when you think about it, insulin is really not the problem with type 1 diabetes. It is with the patients, but it's really a major cost to the healthcare system. So, the insurance companies are willing to pay more for that to get a functional cure, because the plan is that you'll be able to reduce or eliminate the side effects and essentially reduce the cost to healthcare systems around the world. So this is probably going to be one of the most significant products ever delivered in the world. And I think the cell therapy world is really expanding right now. We've been working on this for over 10 years. And you can see a number of other companies coming into the field now, and it's becoming very, very popular. So I think we are looking at multiple functional cures for a number of diseases.